Hey guys, welcome back. So last time we created this reset passwords table, which will keep track of all the requests that we have to reset a password. And then we also created this users table as well, which I'll be using just for these tutorials. But as I said last time, you guys will probably have your own users table, so you can use that. But anyway, what we're going to do in this video is actually insert a request into this reset passwords table. Remember I said it's going to have a code and it's going to have an email address associated to that code. So when the user clicks the link in the email, it'll use the code that they is attached to the link and it will go and get the email address and then update the user with that email address. If that still doesn't make a whole lot of sense to you, don't worry about it. It'll probably make a lot more sense when we come to implement it. So let's get started with that. Let's go across to here and the first thing we need to do is in request reset.php, we need to actually insert the code. So before we send them this link, we need to take this code and insert it into this reset passwords table, okay? So it's a real simple query. I'm gonna do that underneath this email to variable. Let's just say code, because the first thing we need to do is generate a code. So code equals, and then unique ID. So unique ID, and like the name suggests, this generates a unique ID. If you pass true in there, it just adds a little bit more of uniqueness to this. So it's a higher chance that this will be a unique code, okay? So code will now contain a unique ID, very much like this one right here. And this will be different every single time it's generated, so you shouldn't ever have the problem with this generating the same code twice. So all we have to do now is insert this into the table. Let's just say query equals mysqli underscore query. We'll pass in our connection variable, which is con. This comes from our config file, remember, this one right here. The second parameter is the actual query itself. So we'll just say insert into, and the table was called the reset passwords, was it? Yeah, reset passwords. That passwords. And we're going to insert into the code column and the email column. So code and email, because that's the name of these two columns. We don't need to insert into the ID column because we set that to auto increment. You see right here, we have auto increment. So it will handle the value of the ID column automatically. So we're only going to insert into the code column and the email column. And then we're going to say values. And the values are going to be in single quotes, code like this, comma, and then in single quotes again. Going to use email too. Now, of course, I'm not using prepared statements or anything like that. I'm just injecting the variables into my MySQL command. As I briefly mentioned last time, this is just to keep this simple because the focus of this course is not on the MySQL, but more on the sending email functionality. So you, of course, can replace this with PDO and prepared statements if you know how to. But for simplicity purposes, I'm just going to inject my variables straight into my query like this. So anyway, that's our query. It should hopefully insert the row into the table now. And then what we are going to do though, just make sure that this query executed successfully. So we can just say if, and then not query like this, because if this query does not execute successfully, it will return false. So we can say if a query is false, then we just want to say exit, and inside there we'll just put error. So this will just stop executing the rest of the code, and then the user will just see an error code, all right? You can change this error message to whatever you want though. You can say could not generate code or something like that, but it's entirely up to you. Anyway, that means that if now we get to this point, we should have hopefully generated the code. So what I'm also going to do, just real quick before we test this out, I'm just going to take this code variable and let's just put it inside the email just so we can see. Okay, so inside the body, I'm just going to change this string that's part of the email. It's going to say this is the HTML message body, blah, blah, blah. And we can just stick the code on there as well, just to make sure we're getting the correct code through in the email. And of course, I've just realized we're using single quotes here. Now, like I said before, if you want to put a PHP variable inside of a string, you have to use double quotes. So I'm changing these single quotes to double quotes. All right, give that a save and let's go and try that out now. I'm going to refresh the page. And now I'm going to put my email address in there, courses@reesekenny.com. Press reset email, and hopefully we'll see something else. So we see reset password link has been sent to your email. Let's go and check it out. So I'm going to refresh this, and we do see an email. So let's take a look at it. And it looks good. We can see the code right here. Now this code should be the same one that's inside the database. Let's go to our database, and I'm going to refresh the reset passwords table. And you can see this code matches the one that's here. So great, we know it works. And there's our email address too. Ignore the fact that my ID column shows 2 instead of 1. It's just because I inserted into this off camera just to test something out. So yours will most probably show 1 there. All right, so great. We're generating the code and we're including it in the email right now. And we're inserting it into this reset passwords table. All right, so let's go and fix the actual email content because we don't want to say this in the email, of course. We want to actually do a proper message. And we need to give them a link to click as well. So let's go back to our editor right now, and let's just fix the subject and the body, all right? So the subject, of course, can be whatever you want. It can be the name of your website, maybe. But I'm just going to say your password reset link. And the body in here, I'm going to get rid of all of this, actually, but keep the double quotes. I'm going to put an inside of an H1 tag, because you can use HTML here, because we specified it is HTML true. So inside of H1 tag, I'm going to say you requested a password reset. And then close the H1 tag off. Okay, I'm going to press enter to move on to the line below, just so it looks a little bit neater visually. Then I'm going to say, click this link to do so. Okay, and then we want to put this link inside of an actual link. So we need to actually put an anchor tag in there. So A and then href equals, and in single quotes, I'm going to put the link itself, and I'm going to close the anchor tag off after this link word. So like this. Okay, so now the words this link will be the actual hyperlink to where they reset the password. So what's the link going to be? Well, we can create that up here. Above this is HTML true. We're going to create the link. I'll do it underneath this content comment. We'll say URL equals, and then the first part's going to be http://. And then we need the actual link to our website. If you know the website directly, you can just use your website name, something.com. But what we're going to do, though, is actually get the website link dynamically. That means it will work with localhost. So rather than you having to hard code localhost into this, we can do it this way. And that's to just say dot. So we're appending a string, we'll say underscore server like this. So the server array. And then there's an HTTP underscore post attribute in this array. And then what we're going to do is append that with a dir name, so directory name. Inside there, we're just going to put $_server square brackets inside there, php underscore self. So what is that? Well, we can copy that and we can actually output it. So on the index page, it's right at the top. I'm just going to say php and then echo and put that in there like that. Okay. And then if I go to the index page, you should see what it outputs. So I'll go back to index page like that. And we have undefined index. And it's not HTTP post, it's HTTP host, like that. Okay, so that's my mistake. So it's host, not post. And now we see it's got our actual URL. And of course, if we were on our actual live website, of course, this would say yourwebsite.com. It wouldn't say localhost. So we nearly have the link. All we need to do is just combine that with a page name. So go back to here, and just before the semicolon, we're going to do a dot. And then we'll just add the actual page name. So I'll do /, and then reset password.php. This is the page we're going to create very soon. And I'll just say code equals, and this of course is where we'd put the code, but I'll just put a test code in there like that. And then I'll just put the closing double quotes on, and let's go and see what we have. I'll refresh this and make sure the link looks correct. So it looks good right now. We have the full link to this page, and we have this code parameter in the URL too. Great, so there's our link. I'm gonna copy this, all right? This whole double quotes part. Okay, I'm taking that. I'm going to get rid of the rest. We don't need this on the index page anymore. That was just for us to see how it worked. So what I'm going to do is replace these double quotes with that. Okay, and then this code at the end can be replaced with our code variable, which comes from up here. All right, so now this should contain the full link and the code. So let's give it a try. I'm going to refresh the page. I'm going to click on this link and then type in an email address, courses@reesekenny.com. Click reset email. Okay, request has been sent. Let me just go back and see. Refresh this. And here's our email. And you see we have here's our H1 tag, and we have clicked this link to do so. Now, of course, this hasn't worked for some reason, and I think that's because we actually forgot to use the URL variable. We didn't actually put it inside of this href right here. So I've copied the URL variable, and we'll put it in there. So I've saved that. I'll go and refresh the page now, and I'll type my email address in again, courses@reesekenny.com. Press reset email, and we should get another email to our inbox. Here we go. And now we have clicked this link to do so. If I click that link, it takes us to this page. Of course, we have an error because we haven't created this page yet, but we do see reset password and then code equals this. So the next step is just to create this page. Wish all the hashtags, likes, and tweets would find a way to get lost. Yeah, and when I